channel. This is Sheila from Sparkle It Up. Welcome back. If you're new here, welcome in. And if you're returning, welcome back. Like you said, I'm going to do a little whipping chat and plus the official announcement of my event for August. So while we're diamond painting, we'll also be going over the event details. Okay, the event is called A Memory in Time Diamond Painting Event. The event will be happening August 1st through August 31st of this year. For this event, no new start or finish is required. I'll try to do like a little ladder pattern here. I was trying to multi-place and it kind of messed it all up. Made a whole bunch of gaps. Okay. So no new start or finish is required. However, a 30 by 40 centimeter section must be completed in order to win the grand prize. I am encouraging licensed artwork, but it is not required for the regular prizes, but for the grand prize, licensed artwork is required. If you are working on a partial diamond painting, I do require that the whole parcel be finished. You can work on any licensed diamond painting or diamond paint or any licensed craft. Like if you want to do a cross stitch or something like that, you can do that, but all of the prizes will be diamond painting related. Let's see. I am asking that the work be licensed or fan art or custom. You can email me. My email will be down below with any questions or comments that you want answered. You can also comment on this video or any of my other videos after this one with questions, and I will try to get to them as soon as possible. The hashtag for this event will be AMemory2023. I will list my Instagram and the Facebook event page for the event and the Discord group down below. The last week of this month, I will ask that you either email me or post in the Facebook group the photo, not actually a start photo, but kind of a start photo for the last week of July, of your picture that you're going to be working on, showing that it's been kitted up and ready to go. And that way the first week of August will already have the start photos there. And also when you submit your start photo, I want to make sure you know to post also with your start photo the reason behind you choosing that painting, what memory that holds for you. Like for me, I will be working on Carousel Dreams by Andy Russell from Diamond Art Club. Mine holds a special memory for me because I used to take my kids on the carousels when they were little. And especially my oldest son, I took him on the carousel quite a few times. And I lost my oldest son back in 2019, so it just kind of holds that special memory for me working on this. It just reminds me of those days when my kids were little and we would ride the carousel and they'd be like, "Mommy, one more time, just one more time." So it's a special memory. It's a happy memory. The memory doesn't have to be a sad memory. Like, I know several people are choosing to work on, like, cartoon character images from Diamond Art Club because they watch those shows with their kids growing up when their kids were little. Some are working on customs or other pictures for family members that have passed away. And I want to hear all those stories. Because this event, to me, is about being more mindful about the paintings we choose. Because if you're like me, well, most people aren't like me. I live with my mom, her husband, my sister, my son stays here, his friend is staying here, my grandson's here on weekends. It's a household. I only have one room to put diamond paintings in, and that's my bedroom. So I have to, like, switch out my diamond paintings for the seasons and moods and stuff. And so I want people to start thinking about when they're picking a painting, not just because, oh, the colors are pretty. I want people to think, like, am I really going to hang this up? Is it going to hang up on my wall? Or am I just going to roll it up, toss it in the closet, throw it under my bed? And it never gets seen. Because for me, I want all my diamond paintings to be seen. It takes a long time to complete them. Especially for me. It takes me forever to complete one. I'm not like some of these diamond painters out there that can finish 30 to 40 paintings a freaking year. I'm glad they can do that because a lot of people multi-place, and when I multi-place, it turns out like messy. There's a whole bunch of gapping and stuff like that, so I don't like to multi-place a whole lot. I was trying it on this painting and I'm just like, no. Right now I am working on Carousel Dreams, but I'm only working on the outer edges, the sky part. I'm saving the carousel for the event, so I will not work on the carousel at all until the event comes. Right now I'm just like working on the background, the trees, the night sky, the stars, the moon, all that kind of stuff. Flowers, bushes, everything like that. But the carousel itself will be saved for the event. I will try to make a list of all the sponsors. I know we have Jaden Gym Shop. Let me see if I can find that piece of paper. Thank you. Well. Having to move the table over just a little bit so I can get the drawer that the paper is in. I don't see it. I know it's in here. Okay, so from Jaded Gem Shop, she is donating the family portrait diamond painting from her shop. Rose Profit Creations is donating a $25 gift voucher and a code. Diamond Pen Pal has donated a diamond painting pen. DP with Sparklers is donating two $15 gift cards. Lexi Sparkle Crafts is donating a trinket tray. Add More Zest has donated a diamond painting tray. And then we have Amy from Sensible by Design. She is going to be donating a $25 Canadian dollar. Gift card for her shop. And then also there is one more announcement. I will be opening up my Etsy shop in September. So as soon as the event is over, my Etsy shop will be opening. It will be called Sparkle It Up on Etsy, and I will be selling, to start off with, diamond painting putty and cover minders. So I hope when that opens up, y'all will check it out. I would greatly appreciate it. And hopefully everybody has fun in this event, because I hope to do it again next year. I do not have a Google Docs form. I do not know how to make them. I've tried to look it up to see how, and I'm on a laptop, so I don't know if it's because I'm on a laptop and not a desktop computer. It just will not pull up for me how to do it. My grandson's in there giggling like crazy. He's in the kitchen giggling away. But hopefully plenty of you will participate. But I know there is this app that I have on my phone called the Tiny Decisions Wheel. So when you enter your comments for the weekly prizes and stuff like that, I will put your name on that Tiny Decisions Wheel just one time each week. Anytime you comment on that video for a week, for the week, your name will go on the wheel one time. And try to make it to where other people can win some of the weekly prizes too. I have decided that once a person has won a weekly prize, I will take their name off of the wheel until the grand prize drawing. And I have no problems shipping in the United States and paying for that shipping myself. But if you are outside of the U.S., I will be asking that you cover the shipping for the prizes. So if you really want that prize that week, just know ahead of time that I cannot pay $60 for shipping or whatever it would cost. So I know almost everybody has told me that anything outside of the U.S. costs like $60 to ship. I can't pay that. I can't afford that. Hopefully everybody had a fun and safe 4th of July. I didn't do nothing. I sat at home. I do not like fireworks. I like looking at them on TV. I do not like... I like the way they look. I don't like the sound of them. I don't like fireworks being shot off. It sets off my anxiety and my PTSD and all that, and I can't handle fireworks. They're very, very pretty to look at, but I haven't been able to handle fireworks for years. Hopefully everybody's excited for this event, just like I am. I know we're getting a lot of new members in the Facebook group. My event is listed on the Diamond Painting event page, where they list all the events for the year, and on the Google form that they created with all the events, my event is on there. Along with the Facebook group name and the event name and all that good stuff. Yeah, it wasn't a very eventful weekend here. I've been kind of just laying around. My anxiety's been high for the past week or two. I guess I just got a lot on my mind right now. I'm looking for people to talk to, more friends and stuff like that, and I'm hoping that this channel will bring more friends into my life. Right now, I really don't have any besides my sister and my fiance. Then I have a few friends that I talk to on Discord, and I'm trying to make friends with some of the other diamond fans. People in their Discords and on their channels and everything, so hopefully soon I won't have to just sit around and stare at four walls and talk to myself all day. Maybe soon I'll have other people to talk to. It gets kind of lonely. That's weird how I can be in a house full of people and still feel lonely.
Do you need to go out?
He always needs to go out.
Get your ass off of here, lay out.
My mom's dog. She's trying to ask him if he wants to go out, and every time she asks him if he wants to go out, he jumps on my bed. Like, my bed's not outside. kids would keep coming over here and jumping up on my bed like, yeah, okay, I want to go out. And then just hops up here at my feet. But I did at least want to make a short video. I'm not going to stay on long because there is a person going live soon that I want to watch. And I don't edit in any of my videos, so I don't have any editing software, and I wouldn't even know what software to get to edit and how to do it. So all of my videos are all unedited. I know the last video I posted, there was no sound. So this time I made sure to unmute every single one of my things on my stream elements that I record on. That way there would be no mess-ups, hopefully, with sound. But the last video was just showing the two trinket trays that I had gotten from Lexi. And so I have the mermaid tray that she made for me with my name on it. And then I have the teal tray, and I have the dark blue sparkle tray. Which the blue tray is going to be the one in the giveaway. But I will show everything off again when it's time to give those things away for that prize for the week. I will be showing what is going to be given during that video. I will also be throwing in some of my own little goodies that are going to be in my shop, in my Etsy shop, when I open up my shop in September. So anybody that wins the prize will get a couple of goodies from my shop, at least one cover minder and one putty from me. And I'm not telling you the themes of my putties yet, because I don't want nobody stealing my ideas before I can open up my shop. But I also plan on maybe doing some junk journals for my shop later. And you can use them for journaling, or you can use them as a diamond painting logbook. You can use them for just about anything that you want to use them for. That's the whole purpose of a junk journal. It's all purpose. You can use it to write down your little notes in, keep track of things. Use it as a scrapbook. Anything you want them to use it for. Okay. So I am going to head off of here. I know I haven't finished this whole section, but I don't want to miss the video that's coming up live. So I am going to let y'all go, and hopefully I will see y'all all again real soon. I will try to make another video in the next couple of days, and remember to start figuring out which painting you're going to use for the event so that you can email me or post a picture in the Facebook page for my event. Your start photo of it kitted up and ready to go, all prepped and primed. But until then, I hope you all enjoyed this video. I hope you have a safe week. For me, it's Saturday night, so for y'all, it's probably going to be Sunday morning before I post this. I don't know. I might post it tonight before I go to bed. But I would appreciate it if you would consider hitting that subscribe button down below and then hit the bell to make sure you get notifications of when I post the video, because otherwise if you participate in the event, you won't know when I'm posting a video for the event. And even if you're just wanting to watch and carry along with the event, you still need to like and subscribe down below. Well, the like just helps with my algorithms on YouTube, but the more likes, the better, so give that thumbs up. I would appreciate it very much. And I will talk to you guys later. I love you all, and bye-bye.